I was going through my videos and I surprised myself somehow. I found out that I actually haven't talked about this yet. You figure I would because I always talk about racing this, cars that, racing games this and that and all. I talk about ones like Outrun, Need for Speed, and Grid, and other things like that. But I haven't made a thing yet talking about what my favorite racing games are. Then I was trying to figure out how to do this because I've played a shit ton of racing games. I've played more racing games than any other type of game. What I was going to do was like 2D to 3D, but then I decided maybe it'd be better if I just talk about like my favorite ones on for whatever platform it's available on, you know, Genesis, Mega Drive, Super Nintendo, PlayStation, PlayStation 3, you know, whatever. So that's what I'm going to do. I don't know how long this is going to go on for, but I'll just say them. I'll say a little bit about each one, I guess, as to why I chose them. I have no idea where to start, so maybe I guess I'll just start on the Atari 2600. Really, I've only played one racing game on that, and that's Pole Position. I like it. It's simple. It's okay. I also like Pole Position on Vectrex. I've only played that through the emulator, Para JVE, but it's still pretty good. In fact, I actually like that in some ways better than the Atari 2600 one. It's kind of impressive how when you crash, your car explodes in the way it does, because there's no actual fire in the explosion. Well, not that they couldn't do that. It's just saying, like, your parts just fly everywhere. I don't know. Moving on from there, there's one on the Game Gear. I don't know what it's called. Still don't know what it's called. I played it once, or actually a couple times. It's really good. It kind of reminds me of one I actually have on my Genesis Mega Drive. It kind of reminds me of, Super Monaco GP. It reminds me of it. It's not Super Monaco GP. I'm definitely sure of that. What I think it might be is actually it's F1... Grand Prix, I think it's called? I don't know. But, funny thing is, going to that, the Master System, one of my favorite racing games on that is actually F1 World Grand Prix. So that one has the same name, too. I don't know if they're the same games, just one was put on the Game Gear, ported over. Maybe it was, I don't know. The Game Gear and the Master System are both 8-bit things, so maybe that it was. I have no idea. Going to the Game Boy, I guess, it would be F1 Race, I think is what it's called. It's one of the first games that came out for it. On the little picture for the label, the sticker, the game, you see this F1 car with like a rocket booster on. It's one of those few games for the Game Boy that actually had like a four-player split thing. I never did that. I never played with anyone else. I also like Jeep Jamboree on that game. No one I ever mentioned this to has ever heard of Jeep Jamboree. I don't know. I only know about it because I had it. On the Game Boy Advance, there's one called GT Advance. That's all it's called. There was a couple sequels. I'm talking about the first one. It has a yellow, like they put some kind of filter over it. The picture for the cover art is a yellow skyline. I like it. It was fun. You can upgrade your cars. You have a good amount of cars. Most of them are old Japanese cars, so it's kind of like a Nintendo Game Boy Advance handheld portable version of Gran Turismo. Kind of. That's the best way I can put it. I don't know. Moving on from there, also for the DS, I'm going to say Mario Kart DS. That's still probably my favorite Mario Kart game. On the 3DS, even though I never played it, I know for a fact it would be because I like what I've seen, Mario Kart 7. I haven't played it, but I'm pretty sure I'd like it. It's pretty much just like Mario Kart DS. On the N64, my favorite racing game on that would actually probably have to be Mario Kart 64 and Beetle Adventure Racing. It's one of those few games that actually focuses on either one car or one car company. Technically, it counts as both one car company and one car model. You have, although eventually you can unlock weirdo Volkswagen Beetles, new Beetles, like an alien one, which is actually the best car in the game because it has every stat maxed. And there's also a cop Beetle. I don't know. I kind of like Cruisin' Exotica. Cruisin' World and Cruisin' USA, I don't like those. Cruisin' USA is the worst of the three. Cruisin' Exotica is more interesting, at least with the vehicles and also the locations you go in. As the name says, it's exotic. On PlayStation, that's easily Gran Turismo and Gran Turismo 2. However, there's a couple others. Pretty much every Need for Speed game on it, including Porsche Unleashed, which I actually have on the computer still. The first Colin McRae Rally. Wipeout Pure, is it called? I can't remember what it's called. It's one of the Wipeout games on there. It's either the first one or it's like the third one. Or it's an alternate version of the first one, I can't remember. After that would be... Oh crap, I just had the name of it, I forgot. I don't know if this really counts as a racing game, but I do, because you're in vehicles all the time. World's Scariest Police Chases. it's not really a racing game, although you do go fast chasing. I don't know. The game itself is not that good, but I like it. Can't really think of anything else that's on the PlayStation. Oh yeah, there was one, F1 World Championship. Again, another F1 game. Other than that, I can't think of anything else. For the PlayStation 2, there's quite a lot. TOCA Race Driver 3. Some people pronounce it TOCA, I don't. WRC3. I saw someone actually unsubscribed to, they did a video today on it. I like that one so much I never got the fourth one. Gran Turismo 4, I didn't like 3. A-Spec, it's got too little cars in it, and it's just, you know, it seems like a half-assed version. It's kind of like what they do with Gran Turismo 5 Prologue. Instead of giving the full game, they just give you a half-assed version. I don't know. Also, on the PlayStation 2 would have to be, this is the one I'm not so sure about the name, so I'm probably going to get it wrong. I can't even tell you because I can't remember what the frig it's called. It's been so long. It's one of the ones that came out early in its life. On the Xbox, without a doubt, would have to be the first Project Gotham Racing. Then there's also Midtown Madness 3. I like Midtown Madness 3 because it's basically an open-world game. You can drive around, do whatever you want, even when you're not on a mission. I think it was actually a special mode for that. It was called Free Drive or something. Can't think of what else on the Xbox. I never played the first Forza. From what I've seen, I don't like it. I don't like Forza 2 either, but I'm getting ahead of myself. Trying to think if there's anything else I missed. Oh, on the Sega CD, Mega Race 1, 2, and 3. They have Lance Boyle, if you know who Lance Boyle is. They're crazy ridiculous. Oh, those games on there. On the 32, actually, I actually do like Sega... what is it called? Virtua Racing. On the 32X, it's really good. I'm surprised I skipped the Genesis Mega Drive. I completely forgot about that. I like all the OutRun games. That's including OutRunners, Test Drive 2, all the Lotus games, Road Blasters, which I have. And what's the other one? I can't remember the name. Oh, yeah. Nigel Mansell's World Championship and Super Monaco GP in the second one. Although there's also some Japanese ones I like that are exclusive to the Japanese Mega Drive. That is the first F1 Circus and... F1 Circus MD, I think it's called. It's basically just an enhanced version of that. On the Saturn, Sega Rally, without a doubt. Same thing for the Dreamcast, although on the Dreamcast has Sega GT. trying to think if there's anything else I missed. On the Game Boy Color, I really didn't have anything besides Test Drive 6. It's okay. I'd rather play Test Drive 6 on the computer or the Dreamcast. Trying to think if there's anything else. Oh yeah, on the NES, I like Rad Racer, the first one. There really isn't many racing games on that thing. I already said the Master System. I'm trying to think if there's anything else I missed. Nomad is just the portable Genesis Mega Drive. I already talked about Sega CD, Dreamcast, Saturn. Sega's done. Oh yeah, Super Nintendo, Top Gear, Top Gear 2. I really don't like Top Gear 3000 much at all. Nigel Mansell's, it's not called World Championship, but it's called something else. I think it's just called Newman Haas, Nigel Mansell, IndyCar, I think is what it's called. And Super Mario Kart, without a doubt. In fact, in some ways, that's actually my favorite Mario Kart game. That's all for the Super Nintendo. I already talked about N64. On the GameCube, that one F-Zero game, I really like that. That's the only Mario Kart game I don't like is on the GameCube. I was about to call it the Green Cube. there was a racing game I had in the GameCube that wasn't exclusive to it, but I liked it on that the best. I think it was probably Spy Hunter, the first, you know, the remake. I like Spy Hunter a lot too. That's really good on the NES. I liked it in the arcade a lot more. I can't remember most of the names of the one in the arcade, so I can't really say them all, but, like, Sega Dirt Rally is one. Sega Drift is another. Yeah, a lot of Sega ones. The cruising games in the arcade, at least Exotica. That one Fast and the Furious game, which is nothing more than a knockoff of Cruisin' series. Hydro Thunder and basically what's a remake and knockoff of it is called, Hydro Overdrive. Yeah, it's a lot close to Hydro Thunder. I love Hydro Thunder too. I like it best on the Dreamcast. I had the PlayStation version. I rented the N64 version, didn't like it on that. Probably came down to the controller. what and haven't I talked about yet on Dreamcast. All right, let's do some more modern crap. On the Wii, there isn't jack shit for racing games. I've only played it. I never owned it myself. But I like Mario Kart Wii. There's also another one that came out as like one of the launch games is Excite Truck. I also like one called GT Pro Series. A lot of people hate that. I like it. It's just got Japanese cars. Again, it's kind of like GT Pro Advance on the Game Boy Advance and kind of like the first Gran Turismo in a way. Now, this next two, they both, even on the computer, these games are the same on the computer, so I'll just rip them all together unless they're exclusive. Need for Speed Carbon, Need for Speed Most Wanted, which was an exclusive for a while on the Xbox 360, although it's also on the computer. I mean, I have it sitting right next to me. So, I have Carbon right underneath that. Undercover, Most Wanted Carbon, and Undercover. Most Wanted is only on the Xbox 360. It's not on the PlayStation 4 or anything. It is on the GameCube and PlayStation 2 and Xbox. That is the original one. I have it on the computer, so. Split Second. The first Full Auto, and the second one, which is only on... That's the funny thing about Full Auto. The first one's only on the Xbox 360, nothing else, not even computer. And the second one is only on the PlayStation 3. It's called Full Auto 2 Battle Lines, which is actually a better game in most ways. It controls better, at least. It's also on the PSP, though, so... I don't know. Burnout Revenge on the Xbox 360. Burnout Paradise. That's on both. I've played it on both. Forza 3, Forza 4... Forza Horizon. I haven't played 4 Horizon, but from what I've already seen, I'd like them. I just don't like 2. Really, it's the only Forza game I don't like, besides the first one. Trying to think what else there is. A Sega Rally Revo, but it's also called Sega Online Rally, and it's on the Xbox Live Arcade. I don't know. Same game. MotorStorm. MotorStorm Pacific Rift. MotorStorm Apocalypse. Can you tell I like racing games yet? I've probably listed about 80 already. No kidding, I've probably done about 80. On the PlayStation 3, at least that's exclusive. Ferrari, Challenge Ferrari. What's the other one? I already said MotorStorm. There is another one on PlayStation 3. I already said Full Auto 2 Battle Lines. That game's hard, by the way. I can't remember what it is. On the Xbox 60, the other ones I already mentioned that are exclusive. There is one. I don't know why I can't remember. Oh yeah, Project Goth Racing 3 and 4. I don't like 4 much because it's got motorcycles in it, but whatever. I'm trying to think what else. I guess I'm going to have to go to the computer now. I should do 3DO. I've never owned my own 3DO, but I played games on the 3DO. That is the first Need for Speed. I love the first Need for Speed, which is actually called Road and Track Presents the Need for Speed, although it's on the PlayStation. I like the PlayStation version better and the computer version better than the 3DO version, but the 3DO version is very good. Need for Speed, Need for Speed 2, Need for Speed 3, Hot Pursuit, Need for Speed Porsche Unleashed, Need for Speed High Stakes, which a lot of people don't remember, or Porsche Unleashed. As far as the PlayStation or the computer version, I like the PlayStation version better in some ways, and I like the computer version better in other ways. It all depends. It's also in the Game Boy Color. I never played that. Not even on the emulator yet. I'm trying to think what else. I've tried it on the Neo Geo. I like Thrash Rally, and I like Neo Drift Out, but I probably like Thrash Rally more. I don't know, maybe it's just me. I'm trying to think what else before I move on to the last one, which is computer. Okay, for the computer, there isn't really that many exclusive racing games, but... oh yeah, I missed... The one I was missing on the PlayStation 3 that was exclusive is Ridge Racer 7. Some of the ones I have on the computer, I have every test drive up to 6. So I have all, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. I have Test Drive Off-Road, Test Drive Off-Road 2. I like the second one better. VR Sports Powerboat Racing. That's still a racing game. I don't have them all up here with me, so I can't look at them. I like the new Need for Speed Hot Pursuit, the one made by Criterion, even though it's basically Burnout Paradise, which it really is. I like it for itself, but I don't like it for a Need for Speed game, because it's just not a Need for Speed game. I like this one here, which is a good thing I could show it. It's Test Drive. This is not the first Test Drive, it's basically a remake. It's actually known in Europe as Test Drive Brotherhood of Speed. Maybe you're familiar with that. One I forgot on the PlayStation 2 is called Test Drive Eve of Destruction. Only one I can think of left that's actually exclusive on the computer, which I cannot remember its name. I used to have it long, long, long ago. It was like a kind of like a racing rally game. I mean, not rally, a destruction derby game. Oh, how could I forget this? I like Driver, You Are the Wheel Man, which is the first one. Driver 2 is okay, I like it enough. Driver 3 is, I just like messing around. I don't like doing the missions, I just like driving around freely. I like Driver Parallel Lines. I friggin' love Driver San Francisco. I like that and the first one the best. All the rest can go piss off. Grid. I'm looking forward to the second one. I hope that doesn't suck. I like the first Dirt game. I like the second Dirt game. Dirt 3 is kind of crap, but it's better than nothing. Dirt Showdown, I can't stand it, so that's, I might as well mention that. And I don't factor Grand Theft Auto games into this, because I just don't. I'm trying to think if there's anything I missed. Nope, I can't think of anything. So that's it. I listed a ton of games, and I, you know. The only thing I think I forgot to mention was, I mentioned I had the Outrun games on the Genesis Mega Drive. Really, my favorite one out of them all is the first one, Outrun. I like them all, really. Obviously, I like one, certain ones other, over those. If I was to do it in order, I would actually do it Outrun, Turbo Outrun, Outrun 2019, and Outrunners. Outrun is actually my favorite 2D racing series. My favorite 3D racing series would actually have to be Need for Speed prior to Undercover. You know, Undercover back. I like the first Shift somewhat, you know, like I said, Need for Speed Hot Pursuit, the new one, is really just a burnout game. So, yeah, I'm just saying. If I had to pick something that was not Need for Speed, that's actually my favorite 3D racing series, would have to be Driver. Because Driver's always been a 3D series, it's never been 2D, so. Even counting the ones where you can get out of the car, which I like the ones where you can't get out of the car better. I have to say, like the first one in San Francisco, those are my favorite two out of that series. My favorite Need for Speed game, other than the first one, is actually High Stakes and Porsche Unleashed Tide. And if I had to go for anything newer, I would actually have to say Carbon tied with Undercover. It just is, for certain reasons. There's only one Grid game, looking forward to the second one. Forza, if I had to pick whatever one is my favorite out of those, would have to be 3. Fallout 2 I like better than the first one. As far as test drive games go, I like the second one the best. On the computer, because they're different, I like 6 the best. Test Drive Fallout 2 I like the best out of that. Oh, there's also 4x4 Evo and 4x4 Evo 2. I actually haven't showed those. I don't think anyone even knows I own those. Most people don't even know that series. It's actually a game that's on the Dreamcast, the first one. They're pretty fun. The second one's the best one, because it's crazy all the shit you can do in there. But, yeah, I think I went on long enough, so there you go. Those are pretty much every racing game I can think of that I really like for all the different kind of platforms. Notice there isn't many on the handhelds. I just really haven't played many handheld racing games. In fact, even on the PSP, I mean, I had Midnight Club 3 Dub Edition. I like Dub Edition Remix on PlayStation 2 better. And that's about all I could say about the PSP if I had to include that in. So there you go. Thanks for watching and listening, and I will see you next time. I'm actually kind of tempted to watch this again myself and count how many I mentioned. Just out of curiosity. I'll see you next time.